that?
I'll say.
You say.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you. गुरुवर्ग की जय। हरि नाम संकीर्तन हरि पावन आनंद प्रभु की जय। रजनंदन गौर हरि की जय। गौर प्रेमानंद हरि हरि बोल। जय श्री गुरु
जी। जय जय देव।
हेलो
Yeah, sometimes I say different devotees come and stay here, but yes, I live here by myself.
Yoga,
then? Do yoga and yes, bhakti and ashtanga yoga.
Very nice. Very hot.
Yes, it's warm. It's good energy.
I feel completely
drenched.
Jai. Shisha for Jai.
Do you need a towel?
mucho español, torta,
tora, tora,
tora, tora, English,
bara, bara,
yeah, bara, 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 suela, South America,
living in Miami for 20 years,
South America,
Caracas, Venezuela,
Caracas,
Ciudad Prabhupada, going to Venezuela,
Venezuela, México,
no, 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 Mercy, we are happy chanting Hari Bol, Hari Bol.
In India, some current is going on. India, medical
situation.
Man.
This is my dear Maharaj.
Maharaj ki jai.
I don't get to see Maharaj that often, so for him to be here, he's a great source of strength for us throughout the year. So we are grateful here, in the entire Miami Sangha. We're grateful that you're here and that you're able to enliven us with your enthusiasm and your appreciation and bhakti. So, thank you for being here.
ओम ज्ञानतिमिरन्दस्य ज्ञानञ्जनश्रुतेः चक्षुर्मिलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीमहाराज की जय। श्रीगुरुदेव की जय। लाइट्स ऑफ माय रिस्पेक्टफुल ओबेसेंसेस इनटू श्री कृष्ण विष्णुपाद सुतर श्री श्रीमद् भक्तिवेदान्त नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज श्री श्रील भक्तिवेदान्त वन महाराज टू ऑल द वैष्णवस एंड वैष्णवीस असेंबल्ड हियर माय गॉड ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स Very honored to be here, and very fortunate as well. Srila Van Maharaj has accepted me to travel with him for the last 4 months, and some very beautiful realization experiences through that time. And what to say, devotional practice is so rare and so deep, and so we're very fortunate to be here in this association. It's described, it's like a turtle in the ocean. and we have a very beautiful ocean outside. And this turtle is coming up for air. And in that space of time, in that vast ocean, there is one tire, tube, floating in that ocean. And somehow that turtle's head enters the middle of that tire, that tube, and takes its breath of air. What chance of that is there, of that happening? Where would you get a tire in the middle of the ocean, and somehow or another a turtle happens to be swimming by, coming up for air, and comes through that the hole of that tire. So devotional service, so being in association with a sadhu, a pure devotee, is that rare. It's described, Brahmanda Brahmite Konabhagavan Jeev. So traversing this Brahmanda, these universes, the jiva, the soul, the living entity, is traveling from the repeated cycle of birth and death over 84 million species of life and comes to this human form of life that is so rare. That in that human form of life, you get a chance to meet somebody who is actually showing us how to come out of this cycle of birth and death. And that is also so rare. So we're very, very fortunate. And one of the qualities of devotees is they always appreciate, they're always in gratitude of that association, of that ability, of that chance, of that good fortune to be in that association. And then to take advantage of that association. And what is that advantage? To listen to his words of realization, to listen to his words of experience, of all those years that they themselves, the sadhus, have been practicing. Who would give you that jewel freely, without any cost? Who would share their life's experience, their life's learning, their life's teachings with you, without any expectation? Who would dedicate their lives completely, without any other distraction, and only having that one goal, one focus, is to achieve that highest goal of bhakti, pure devotion. And they have achieved that dedication throughout Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, to their spiritual lineage of Bhaktivedanta Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, to Trika Maharaj, to Bhakti Pragyan Kesha Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada, all the disciplic succession, all our teachers, they have passed this down from one generation to another. And we say that we don't know Krishna. We've heard about Krishna. We've heard about Srimati Radhika. We've heard about his friends and his mother and his father. We've never met them. We've never experienced them. We've never been in their presence. We've heard about this personality called God, but we don't know. We've never met. How can we have a relationship with them unless we've met somebody who's met them? Yeah? Isn't it? So having that fortune to be in that Guru Parampara, in that line of disciplic succession, from Krishna, from Brahma, Narad, Vyas, all of the Parampara for thousands of years, they've been coming down, unbroken chain. And we're so fortunate to have that chain continue with us and have that presence here in this room, isn't it? So, if it touches your heart, let it touch your heart.
Namasestang Manuti Sachi Patra Sarupam Rupam Tasagrajam Rupurim Mathurim Gustavatim Radha Kundam Girivaromoho Radhika Madhavasham Prapta Jasya Pratita Kripaya Sri Guru Tannatosinam Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vasadi Sri Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama Rama Rama
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
So first of all, I offer my humble, respectful obeisances unto lotus feet of my Guru Pad Padma, Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnu Pad, Ashtutara Satasya Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj, and Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnu Pad, Ashtutara Satasya Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Srila Narayan Goswami Maharaj. Simultaneously, I offer my humble, respectful Dhanavad Pranam. Lotus feet of Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnu Pad, Ashtutara Satasya Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, Srila Gauravinda Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Rakha Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Vama Puri Goswami Maharaj, and all senior devotees and all Vaishnavis, and present all of my respectful guests. Just I want to speak few words, but I want to know. I think all you are coming here. Who is a newcomer here? Is the first time? He comes this time, first time? What is your name, Prabhu? Your name?
Santino.
Santino. Your name?
Yeah.
This is the first time you are? No.
Here? Not the house, but.
No, not the house. Many houses, no problem. No, you are coming in our Krishna consciousness in Kolkata. Okay. Your name?
Sunanda.
Sunanda. Okay, I think it's Sunanda. Okay. Nice name.
Predicted name.
Okay. Just I want to say a few words. This human life is very, very rare. Try to first understand these things. Gurudev Srila Narayana Goswami Maharaj, when he spoke Harikatha, first he used this word. This human body is very, very rare. First we should realize this thing. After 8.4 million pieces, then many births, many lives, you also spend many kinds of different pieces. Cats, dogs, animals, many lives, many pieces you also spent. Then Lord mercifully He gives us the human body. Because this human body is very rare, not so easy to get again also. You believe or not? Sometimes I'm saying you are theist or atheist. This is not our subject. But it is sure this human body is very, very real. You believe rebirth or not? This is not our subject also. But this is true. The human body is very, very real. Because Lord gives us this human body only for how will we attain His abode dham. Because only the human body we can do perform bhajan and sadhana. So our Srimad Bhagavatam very clearly explains this verse. Labdha sudurlam idam bahu sambhavante manusam arthadam anittam apyadhira turnam jatena pratet anumittum javat nishesa visakhalu sarvata sad. Hey baby, Jagannath, hey! Mom touch, then automatically stop. Magic power, eh? Only mom touch body, then crying funny. So just I also explain this way, this human body is very, very rare. Eating, sleeping, defending and mating, these four things are common. This is true. all we are eating, sleeping, defending. This is the nature of the conditioned soul, Buddha Jivas. Buddha Jivas means conditioned soul. Who is not eating? Did you eat or not? What did you eat?
Fruits and vegetables.
Okay, fruits and, yeah? Some vegetables. Eat. Okay, you are vegetarian,
huh? Yes.
Oh, very nice, good. Cats, dogs, cow, animals, they also eating. We are also eating. Yeah? Sleeping. We are human beings also sleeping. How many hours you are sleeping?
Too many. More than seven.
More than seven. Wow. This is common. This is not too much. This is also need for body. 6 to 7 hours can sleep. No problem. This is not too much. If you sleep 10 hours, 20 hours, this is too much. It's like Kumbhakarna. You know Kumbhakarna?
No.
If you heard the name of Purna Kumbhakarna? Oh, you don't know. Who knows about Kumbhakarna? Who is the Kumbhakarna? The brother of Ravana. You know Raman? You heard Raman? Raman, the brother of Rama, Ravana, he was sleeping, continued, 6 months. How many months you sleep? 6 hours. Kumbhakarna, he slept?
Six months.
6 months continue. Then one day, wakes up. Then eating, whole day eating. Then again sleeping and again continue?
6 months.
6 months. Then once a year?
He's awake.
One day, wake up and again sleep. So just I also explain this way. Eating, sleeping, this is the nature of the world. Body need also this. You will not sleep, then you will become crazy also. Mm-hmm. Then brain will not work also. Then according to science, you have to prepare you to sleep. Mm-hmm. If you are prepared to take rest. If you not prepare time to take rest, sleep and eating, then your body will not work. If you drive your car, so after 2 hours, certain hours, you have to
rest.
In the same way, our body also does. Body wants a rest. So eating, sleep, just I also coming back, this eating, sleeping, defending. Defending means quarreling with each other. We are human being. Sometimes you are quarreling. What we are quarreling? You married?
Divorce. Divorce.
Sometimes you quarrel your wife or girlfriend or boyfriend, I don't know. Quarreling,
yes.
This is the thing. Nature of the world. Because sometimes you are very difficult to compromise to each other. I want these things, but he does not want these things. So that time also what? Quarreling, compromise. Very difficult to compromise. That morale, So defending, this is the nature. But animals, also they are also quarreling. Fighting to each other. Once part of the street dog, if you come and another part of the street dog will come, they will be also what? Quarrel. Right?
Monkeys
also. You have got Vrindavan. So many monkeys. Who went to Vrindavan? You went to Vrindavan. You? What is your name?
I'm going.
What is your name?
Yesenia.
You went to Vrindavan? No.
I'm going.
When you are going?
I'll be there February
13th. Oh, very nice. You are lucky. Very good.
Okay.
Yeah. Wow. You go to Vrindavan, you can see. But very careful, there are so many.
One way ticket.
Oh. You one way ticket?
One way ticket.
Not return.
You are so lucky. Okay, good. You stay in Vrindavan. So just I also turn back these things, eating, sleeping, defending, mating, this is the nature of the conditioned soul. All those beings doing the same thing. But to bhajan and sadhana, bhajan sounds to chant Lord's holy name, worship to Lord, this is very, very rare. Last time I also came here, I worshipped Thakurji, this Thakurji. So I am saying because the common of the human being and animals, birds, animals. These 4 things. But why the speciality of human life? To bhajan and sadhana, Krishna naam, and association with sadhu sangha. 2 things. chant holy names and associate with sadhu. What is the meaning of associate sadhu? Listen Hari Katha. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare.
No, why not? It's superficial happiness, I think.
You want superficial?
No, no, in the material world is superficial. You're happy for one moment and then.
What do you want?
I mean, I'm happy in this material world when I'm around association and I sometimes feel Krishna's presence and just feel a lot of bliss.
In this material, no one will become happy. Mm-hmm. Because this is the nature of this material world giving many kinds of distress. Mm-hmm. Right? This is the nature. And all the living entities suffer in the three folds of Maya. What is the three folds of Maya? Do you know? Adhyatmik, Adidaivik and Adi Bhautik. Adhyatmik means, Adi Daivik means some kinds of distress are coming from demigod and demigoddess. That is called Adi Daivik. That is heavy rain, earthquake, you know, few months before you. Miami also are coming.
Hurricane.
Everybody go, maybe Miami will be flooded and destroyed. Everybody go, but nothing happened, no? Something is maybe. That's it. Yeah, because ocean is very close. And if the big waves and water coming up, then everything will go flood. Fire will go. So these types of... So I am saying this because this is called the Adi Daivik. Some kinds of distress are coming from demigod and demigoddess. That is called Adi Daivik. Many kinds of disease also coming from demigod and demigoddess. Adi Bhautik. Some kinds of distress are coming from others living entities. Cats, dogs, snake, bites. That is called Adi Bhautik. Adhyatmik means some kind of distress are coming from our mind. Your mind some disturbed or not?
Always.
Always.
Always. Your mind. There's always some distraction.
Mind is disturbed. This is the nature of it. And in this material world, this nature, our whole body every day changing. One day small boy, then young youth, then old age, then one day we die also. Who wants to die? Anyone? Raise your hand. Who wants to die? No one. Why? Because you love this body. You love this body. All we love this body. And so much love and affection this body also. For this regard, we don't want to give up this body. Only crazy person will say, I will die. Absolutely not. Let's give an example. Once one person, he was going towards the river. That time rainy season, rain also, not heavy rain, little drizzling. Little rain kind. And he took one, what is a big candle, you know?
Candle.
Candle,
like.
Candle, big candle. You know?
Like a torch?
Kerosene. Midnight, then one sadhu met and asked, hey, where are you going? Midnight, where are you going? Rain, little rain also, and also cold. Where are you going? He told, I am going to commit suicide. Where going?
Commit suicide.
To commit suicide. I give up my body because every day quarreling with my wife and children, it is better. I will give my body and jump from the bridge in the ocean. And that time it is okay. So why you are holding this candle?
Torch. Torch, it's called a torch.
Torch, okay. Why are you holding this? That time he told, oh, today is a little bit rain, maybe snake will come and bite to me. Oh, you are going to give up your body. Actually, this is not true. Some momentary, some times coming, that your mind disturbed, thinking I will commit suicide. That is called the depression. When the people depression coming, maybe that time he commits suicide and hanging. What do you do? Rope and hanging. And maybe drinking poison or taking the gun and. Actually, this is what is coming. This is called depression. Depression of mind. These are the things. But our Shastra is saying, you should not commit this, suicide. If you commit suicide, you will become ghost. Very carefully. Do you want to become ghost? What is a ghost? Ghost actually, they are suffering body. Ghost. Our Padma Puran also glorifies about Srimad Bhagavat Mahatma. A very nice, beautiful story, the story of Gokarna and Dhundukari Katha. You know this story? Who knows? Gokarna Dhundukari Katha? Don't know? Okay, a little bit briefly I tell you, then you understand. There was one Brahmana, his name was Atmadeva Brahmana. His wife's name was Dhunduli. Just remember his name, Sanskrit name, Dhunduli. But he has vast of wealth, money, but he had no sons and daughter. So he became very upset. One day on sadhu came and he also asked the sadhu, they give some blessing, I get one son. Then sadhu told, it is impossible, in your previous life, first life, you did not perform any pious activities, you will get son. Not only this, 7 births you cannot get son. And that time the Atmadeva Brahmana, he hold the lotus feet of sadhu. No, anyhow you change my life. That time sadhu chanted some Pesal mantra, Pesal mantra. And gave one fruits. Okay? Maybe mango, guava, something this. And he told, if you feed this fruit your wife, then your wife, she will become pregnant and she will give birth, birth a baby. So Atmadeva Brahmana, he brought that the special fruit and offered her wife, his wife. What is the name of his wife? Dhunduli. You forgot. Dhunduli. Remember, name just name. But she was little bit other-minded. She was thinking, if I eat this fruit, then I will become pregnant, my stomach will be very big, I cannot walk, and if the thief will come, thief will be take everything, maybe kill to me, I cannot run. Many things is in his mind, just is speculating, thinking. Because some people are thinking, many things was thinking. She's thinking, no, I don't want to eat this fruit. She called her one very far relative sister. Far relative sister. She told, I will give some money to you. So when you give birth to your baby, you give to me. This is enough. Then I will propaganda, I give birth the baby. People thinking, I give birth the baby. She was poor. Her relative sister, she was very poor. So thinking, anyhow, I can give. So Dhunduli, she took the fruit and she feed the fruit in her cow. Something happened because Santa Mahatma gave the fruit that is very powerful. And if sadhu will give anything to you, that is very powerful. So, that cow ate the fruit. Then what happened? This cow also became pregnant. Then here, after 9 months, Dhundukari's relative sister, she gave birth to one newborn baby, and night time she also offered to Dhundukari, Dhunduli. At same day, say same night, the cow, she also gave birth to the baby, and newborn baby, as a human baby. Just his ears is as like cow. For this regard, gave his name, what is his name?
Gokarna.
Go means cow, karna means ears. The babies took birth from the womb of the cow. For this regard, gave his name Gokarna. Go means cow, karna means ears. Babies' eyes just as like cows. And now, night time, Dhunduli, she also brought her relative sister's son. And then daytime and morning, she declared, oh, I gave birth to the baby. Before she was pretending, I'm pregnant, put some cloth on her stomach, and this thing. And now, she told, oh, I gave birth to the baby. But no one knew. Even her husband also, he did not know what happened. Now Atmadeva Brahmano very happy. And everybody told, oh, Brahmano, you are very happy. Lord gives everything so. And at a time your wife, she gives birth to the baby. And at a time your cow also, she gives birth to the baby. Anyhow, Atmadeva Brahman, he nourishment added in two babies, newborn baby. Dhunduli, she gave her son's name Dhundukari. So now Atmadeva Brahman, he nourishment and two sons. What is it? By this mercy of sadhu, that boy born, he is very calm and quiet. That means Gokarna. Gokarna is sadhu. Following all the rules and regulations of society, doing bhajan and sadhu. A Dhundukari, completely stupid nonsense and rascal. From his childhood, he's doing bad things also. Going to school, stealing, even also killing the babies also. Taking one knife, just kill. Very cruel. Not reading, nothing. Eating, drinking, this way. Bad habits coming. Very quick. And Gokarna, he learned all Shastra, Ved, Puda, Puran, Upanishad, Ramayana, Bhagavad, Gita, everything. Nature difference. You understand? Mm-hmm. Completely nature difference. Gokarna, he is pious person. A Dhundukari is completely what? Stupid, nonsense and rascal. When both of the grow up, Dhundukari asks his father give money. And by force taking money from his father and going to the, and what is called? Alcohol place?
Bar.
Nightclub, drinking, alcohol, stupid nonsense, even going to the prostitute and doing everything. All kinds of sinful activity. His life completely what? Full of sin. And Gokarna, he chanting holy names, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare.
I'm going to be staying near the
Ishkan Balaram
temple.
Ishkan Balaram temple, okay. Hare Katha. So Nagmudi Dev, Atmadeva Brahman, finally he left house and went to Vrindavan to bhajan and sadhu. Gokarna, he saw his brother, only disturbance, midnight coming, drinking alcohol and making disturbance. Those are drinking alcohol. And every day he also beating his mother, give money. Then Gokarna realize this house is as like Narak. Complete your hell. So Gokarna also left his house and he went to a pilgrimage place, Tirtha Yatra, you know, pilgrimage. Yeah. Now Dhundukari every day asked his mother, give money. Where is my father's money? Give him. And beating. Then one day, Dhunduli, he also commits suicide. And jumped in the river and commits suicide. Now Dhundukari, he is alone. And got no money. All his money completely were finished. Then he's stealing here and there, even he also drinking alcohol, getting money here and there. And five prostitutes he also kept in his house. His house completely were full of sinful activities. One day Dhundukari, he went one treasury of king, king place. And he also robbed some money, jewels and some valuable things. Night time he came, and that time he also drank alcohol and gave that the valuable jewels that the five prostitutes. And that time five prostitutes, they saw, oh, this is very valuable things, and this is coming from king's treasury. Maybe tomorrow early in the morning, king's man will come, police will come and catch to us and put in a jail. So for this regard, the five prostitute lady, they think, what will do now? It is better. That time also night time. Dhundukari, she drank so much alcohol, his body, when you drink so much alcohol, cannot speak also. Understand? That time five prostitute lady, him, tied his hands and legs with the rope. And bitterly beating, but he did not give up his body. That time they also put one burning stick, you know, burning stick, and also put in his mouth. Still he was not give up his body. Then again they also again and again beating, and taking that the burning stick and also beating bitterly. Then finally, Dhundukari, he left his body. That time four prostitute lady took his dead body and put one oil. You know oil? Oil, understand?
No, oil.
Oil. Where the water is coming. And put in there. And also covered with one big stone. Do you understand? But do you understand?
Poso.
Spaniel. I know. And that also covered with one big stone. Now inside there. And the night and that prostitution they took all the valuable jewels and they ran away. Now Dhundukari, he left his body. And he became ghost. Because one who left his body in this situation, he will become also ghost. And actually, ghost body is very, very painful. Actually, ghost body is very painful. And, but that body is subtle body also. Sometimes manifest, and cats, dogs, animals, even fire, if anybody will come, also they will make the fear. And if it will come, then ha! You cannot see, there's some person. But also coming in front of you, making this sound, they will be afraid. If I tell you, maybe night time you cannot sleep. And ghost body is very, very dangerous. You cannot see and not person in your house, but making sound. Or sometimes making sound. You can, oh my God. And sometimes it's automatically fire coming. Sometimes cats, dog, ghost means what? Making different so bodies. You cannot believe. Have you seen ghost or not? Who has seen ghost? You have seen? Where?
My parents' house.
Your parents' house? You?
Yeah, my parents' house.
Have you seen ghosts?
The fan turns on by itself.
I haven't
the
seen
by
them,
itself.
But I've felt them.
Ghost what is it? So much said. If I touch you, then sometimes also big eyes and do. So now Dhandukari, he is now ghost and disturbed to all the villagers. Throwing the stone and things and making disturbance to everybody. So many people also left the village. His house completely what? Abandoned. Abandoned house. This is.
Ghost is staying there.
So now coming in this way, nobody knew what happened and how Dhandukari left his body. Nobody even knew. But villagers, they realized why this body, this house, so many sound coming and night time. Here Gokarna, he also traveling in many pilgrimage place. Then after 3-4 years, again he returned back his own village. When he returned back his own village, then the old villagers told, your brother left body and he became ghost and he disturbed all our villagers. Gokarna, one day he was sleeping in his own house, same house. Then when Gop Kumar is sleeping, midnight, ghost came. And also first ghost also sucking his bed. Then Gokarna, he said, what is he sucking my bed? No earthquake. Or what happened? Then after a few minutes, then sound coming. Ho, 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 ho. Then he opened the door. Nobody there. Then after a few minutes, again sleep. Gokarna, again. So some fire, big fire coming. And sometimes you make him different of form and body. And making also a fear to him. Gokarna is a devotee. Chanting holy names. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And if you are pure devotee, ghost will not come in front of you. And if ghost will come in front of you, that automatically the ghost will deliver from this material. And my Guru is Vaman Goswami Maharaj. At the photo of Babu Goswami. He delivered many ghosts. You may read the life history of Sri Vaman Goswami Maharaj. He delivered many ghosts. So now coming in this way, just I also explained to you. So Gokarna, midnight, he wakes up and asks, hey, who are you? That time, ghost told, hey Gokarna, I am your brother Dhandukari. I am your brother Dhandukari. And I left my body this way, this way. And he told everything. How did he left his body? Everything he told. Listen, I am your brother, Dhandukari, and I left my body this way, that prostitute, they also bitterly beat me and put in the
well,
and this way. Now I become ghost. Brother, please deliver me from this body. That time Gokarna told, Dhandukari, don't worry, I will deliver to you. So Gokarna, he gave many kinds of fire sacrifice, That is called Sanskrit, the Pindodan. Pindodan, understand? Some kind of special mantra and offering some foodstuffs and different pilgrimage place. But still, he did not deliver from his ghost body. That time Gokarna, one day he chanted some special mantra of Lord Sun God. Surya Deva, Sun God. Then Sun God came and Sun God told, "Hey Gokarna, your brother Dhundukari only will deliver if you give Bhagavat Katha. That is called Bhagavat Saptah. Only Srimad Bhagavat Katha, your brother will Dhundukari deliver from his ghost body." This is true. How is powerful Bhagavat Katha, Hari Katha? Why I am saying? Because Hari Katha is very powerful. If you listen Hari Katha with faith, then ghost will never come in front of you, 100% guarantee. And after your death, you will attain to Golok Vrindavan. Balo Vrindavan Vihari Lal Ki Jai. So Gokarna, he gave Hari Katha, Bhagavat Katha. What Katha? You understand Bhagavat? Srimad Bhagavatam. You understand Srimad Bhagavatam? Tell to all. Pastimes of Sri Krishna and his devotees. That's called Srimad Bhagavatam. Eh? Yeah, this Srimad Bhagavatam. Where is Srimad Bhagavatam? Yeah. So to her, maybe she does not know what is Srimad Bhagavatam. Eh? Bring one Srimad Bhagavatam.
Can I show Srimad Bhagavatam? He has it in here.
Because she's new. Srimad Bhagavatam. 7 days. And Gokarna. And he gave Bhagavad Katha and special chanting some special mantra and also called his brother. After 7 days, then one chariot came from Vaikuntha. And Dhundukari gave up his ghost body and made a very nice, beautiful demigod body and seated on the chariot and attend to Vaikuntha Dham. Balo Vrindavan Vihari Lal Ki
Jai.
Everybody saw. Looks good to her. You read Srimad Bhagavatam. How is powerful Hari Katha, Bhagavat Katha. If you listen to Bhagavat Katha 7 days, 100% guarantee, all your sinful are predestined, and you attain to Guru Vrindavan. But you have to listen Hari Katha with firm faith. Take the Hari Katha. And concentrate your mind as like Parikshit Maharaj. Parikshit Maharaj, he listens Srimad Bhagavatam, lotus leaves of Sukadev Goswami Pad. How many days?
Seven days.
This Bhagavat Katha is very powerful. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram.
And that time all audience, they become very surprised. They ask to Gokarna, "We are listening Bhagavat Katha from your mouth, but your only your father, only your brother, Dhundukari, he delivered from this material world, why you are not?" That time Gokarna told, "You listen Bhagavat Katha, but you are not thinking. Sarvanun yuva phalanam, mananirutu phalam. Only listen Bhagavat Katha, this you cannot get the perfect fruit. You listen Bhagavad Katha and simultaneously you remember. You have to remember. Don't forget. Smaran. Shravan and Smaran. Listen and also
remember.
Then again Gokarna, he gave Bhagavad Katha and all audience listening and remembering, all they also delivered on this material. Bala Vrindavan Vihari Lal Ki Jai. So always listen Bhagavat Katha. This is in Kali Yuga. In this Kali Yuga, Bhagavat Sravan. Listen Hari Bhagavat Simad Bhagavatam. And chant holy names. Two things. Chant holy names. And listen Bhagavat Katha. This is very important. Without chanting holy names, your life will not be successful. Everybody chant holy names. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Okay, now prepare Arati, 30, and again our 6, next program also, 6:30, 6 o'clock. So now take Prasad and do Arati, then Prasad. for just 5 minutes, chant Hari Krishna, Malo Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
Oh, no.
Thank you.
अनंत कोटि वशन गौर ब्रह्मान ओम वृंदावई तुलसी देव प्रियावई केशवश्च कृष्ण भक्ते प्रदे देवी सत्वत्वै नमो नमः पंचाकल्पतरुहस्य कृपा सिंधु भयेव च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो
वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः
जय श्री गुरुदेव की
जय
जय श्री
राधे
Shri Bhakti Vedanta Bandhana Jaki
Jai Jai